Hi, I'm Robin Meloy Goldsby, author of Rhythm, a novel. I'm talking to you today from my living room in a small village outside of Cologne, Germany. Thanks for stopping by. Rhythm explores the world of music, specifically the world of jazz, R&B, and funk music. It also delves into the role that female musicians play in instrumental music. Although I hope to immerse my readers in the realities of life as a professional female musician, this environment serves primarily as a backdrop for my major theme, which is the importance, the extreme importance of love and respect in a child's life, whether that comes from a parent, a nurturing environment, or a music teacher. Rhythm reveals the tragic beauty of human resilience, the restorative powers of love and laughter, and the way one girl's music, steady, solid, and extremely courageous, helps to mend her shattered heart. Jane Bowman lives in Swickley Heights. Now that's Pittsburgh's version of old money swank. And she lives there with her father and two eccentric maids, Mary One and Mary Two. She attends a fancy private high school, practices the drums like crazy, and struggles to recover from the loss of her mother in a New York City nightclub fire. When Leo Wainwright, Jane's quirky sidekick, introduces her to Olivia Blue, a music school teacher at a Pittsburgh reform school for teenage boys, Jane's passion for music blossoms. After graduation, she moves to New York City, where she encounters the best and the worst of the music business. She has a stint in an all-female soul band. She has a tour with R&B superstar Bobby Angel. And finally, a chance to lead her own remarkable group, Planet Funk. When Jane's band performs in a popular New York City nightclub, disaster strikes again. And Jane's life changes in ways that she could never imagine. Without giving away the plot, I'd like to read a brief excerpt from the end of the book. This is Jane's voice. I've learned to play music. I've learned to teach it. I've even learned to touch it, to reach into the core of a song and find the gentle throb of its subtle meaning. Here's what I tell my students. Life can be like a songbook of your own greatest hits. You play through your repertoire, trying to keep the tempo steady. But unexpected comedies and tragedies cause you to speed up, slow down, jump to the coda, end the tune before you've resolved the cadence, or come to a grinding halt because things have veered out of control. You hesitate, you threaten to rip the score into a thousand scraps of nothingness, and you want, more than anything, to kick over the music stand and quit. But then, surprisingly, you feel the pulse of life coursing through your veins. You take the recovery option and move on to the next tune. Shaken, you pick up the sticks, the horn, the bow, the conductor's baton, and give it another try. You work through the music, taming the chaos of a difficult phrase by playing one simple note after another, slowly moving forward, practicing, till you get it right. Maybe your last groove was the best one you'll ever play. Or maybe the next one will turn out to be even better. That's Jane. Thanks for listening. You can check out my first book, Piano Girl, a Memoir, which received a starred review from Publishers Weekly. You can also have a listen to one of my three CDs, Somewhere in Time, Songs from the Castle, or Twilight. Also, you might want to visit our website, www.goldsby.de. That DE stands for Deutschland. I live in Germany. And there, when you visit our website, you can pick up links that will take you to my appearances on NPR's All Things Considered, The Leonard Lopate Show, or NPR's Piano Jazz with Marion McPartlin, which is a really fun program. Thanks for reading the first 5,000 words of Rhythm. I hope when you're reading them, you can hear the music. It's there.